And today we're going to talk about carburetors and the inlet of where your gas goes into a carburetor. Carburetors have gas that go in, and it goes in through the side of the carburetor. I've got a couple of carburetors here as an example, but a lot of times what happens is the little plastic fitting that goes on the carburetor breaks off, and so what you end up with is a little brass piece that sticks out the side. Now, one quick connection you can do is you can take an O-ring clamp like this and clamp it back together, and that will solve the problem, but it's not very stable, and sometimes those hoses will pop right off. In general, what you're going to need is a pair of vice grips like this. Take a pair of vice grips, you vice grip onto the side of the brass fitting, and you twist. And what will happen is that brass fitting will pop right out. You'll take your new fitting, which is just like this. You notice that the plastic is connected. That's permanently epoxied in place. You're going to take it, and you're just simply going to shove it back into the space. Now, with the plastic on it, you can tap it ever so slightly and give it a little bit of a twist and reset that brass fitting back inside, and that will solve your problem. Be sure not to twist sideways, because if you twist sideways, what you run the risk of is breaking the casting on the side of the carburetor, and that'll ruin your carburetor so it doesn't work. But just, you know, gently twist and press that brass fitting back into place, and you should be good. You can see on the inside how it just pressure fits in. But that's how you replace the connector for your fuel line onto a Briggs & Stratton carburetor. If you have any other questions, be sure to write us.